Melania and Donald Trump place host dinner with Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe at Mar-a-Lago. Palm Beach, Florida, seeking to reassure Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe of their close alliance ahead of planned talks with North Korea, the Trump administration has signaled it is open to considering exempting Japan from new steel and aluminum tariffs that Abe opposes. Hosting Abe at his Mar-a-Lago resort in Palm Beach, Trump said the tariffs could be a topic during the visit, which comes as Trump prepares for an historic summit with North Korea's Kim Jong-un. Trump also gave Abe a win on Tuesday, pledging to raise the issue of Japanese citizens abducted by North Korea, a top Japanese priority, in his meeting with Kim. But Trump later suggested there was one area where he and Abe would have to agree to disagree, the Trans-Pacific Trade Partnership, which Trump pulled the U.S. out of days after his inauguration, but has recently said he might be open to rejoining. While Japan and South Korea would like us to go back into TPP, I don't like the deal for the United States, Trump tweeted, following a dinner with Abe and their wives, too many contingencies and no way to get out if it doesn't work. Bilateral deals are far more efficient, profitable and better for our workers. The two-day Trump-Abe summit played out amid growing tensions between the two countries over North Korea and trade. Japan has warned that Kim may simply be trying to buy time and has raised concerns that the U.S. might not press Kim to abandon his short- and medium-range missiles, which pose an immediate threat to Japan, as they discuss the country's nuclear weapons program. Japan has also been questioning why it wasn't granted exemptions to Trump's protectionist measures on steel and aluminum when most other key U.S. allies, among them Australia, Canada, the European Union and Mexico, have been. Paula Patton says what she predicts about Meghan will come true someday. Meghan Markle is set to officially join the royal family next month. But Paula Patton believed that this unlikely event would happen a long time ago. The 42-year-old actress recently claimed that she predicted Markle, 36, would become a member of the royal family one day. The Warcraft actress and her then-fiancé Robin Thicke recruited the Suits actress, who was working as a freelance calligrapher at the time, to do the calligraphy on their wedding invitations, and at the time, she thought she was meant to be royal. She told Entertainment Tonight, "I met her because she helped me with my wedding invitations. She had this beautiful writing. That moment I feel like I said something to her, like, you were meant to be royal. She was just so graceful and lovely, and actually really kind." Meghan, who is set to wed Prince Harry next month, used to even teach calligraphy when she worked at Paper Source in Beverly Hills in 2004. Winnie Park, CEO of Paper Source, said, "It was her part-time job as she was going through auditions. She taught calligraphy and hosted a group of customers and instructed them during a two-hour class on how to do calligraphy. She's someone who really enjoys the creative aspects of the job, who enjoys helping people, and also someone who enjoys making creative projects come to life. Our sales associates are screened for their creativity." She would have advised customers on projects from wedding invitations to creating personalized stationery to gift wrapping. She has talked about being a big fan of custom stationery and think it's the best gift to give a friend. And Park thinks Meghan and Harry will send a personal invitation to their close friends and family before their big day. She added, "They are a couple who would send a personal touch to close friends and family. My guess is they will likely have a very personal invitation going out specifically for events before or after the formal ceremony." A big trend we are seeing is couples addressing invitations with beautiful stamps from around the world. They could choose stamps from places that mean the most to them, Botswana, the UK and the US. "She's such a Renaissance woman. She's definitely a modern royal to be, and this is going to be a modern royal wedding.